So it's not boasting, no, it's just the truth. Amen. All right, let's welcome our audience from all over the world that are joining us live on the internet. Everybody make a joyful noise. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. So wherever you're watching us from all over the world, this is Ignite. And I want to welcome you formally because you are going to be blessed and the knowledge of Jesus is going to bring freedom to our soul. Hallelujah. So we started the last fellowship. Started looking at destiny. You know, scriptural and biblical destiny. You know, Christian destiny, if you like. What is destiny? I said the last time that destiny, or let me just rephrase what I said, the definition I gave you the last time. Destiny is not suggestive. Destiny is not a suggestive thing. It's not suggestive. Destiny is inevitable, a fixed future or event. Either a fixed future or event for somebody or something. That's what destiny is. All right? Destiny is something that is fixed. It's an event, a future that is fixed. And that future or that event is unchangeable. That's what destiny is. Destiny is something that is not changeable. You can't change it. You can't change destiny. Now, I know that I'm going against the traditional norm. But the traditional norms, as long as it is not in line with God's truth, according to the word of God, it's not of God. And to say that somebody has destiny, destiny is the work, the determination, the decision of a greater or a superior being. You cannot say anything is destined to be, except something greater than that thing is the one that is going to destine it. Am I making sense? If I say I have destiny, something greater than me must have fixed a future, a thing, or tomorrow, or an event concerning me. Something greater than me that I cannot confront, I can't challenge, I can't stop. Am I making sense? So destiny is the work of a supreme being. A supreme being. A being that is supreme. A being that is not subject to right. It's not subject to right. You know, if you say something is not subject to right, that means he will never get to a point to apologize for whatever he's done or he's going to do or has done in the past. Thank you, Lord Jesus. So if you say you have destiny, it means you believe in a greater or higher power. Something bigger than yourself. Because you can't say you have destiny if you don't have something that is bigger than you. Destiny is something or an event or a future fixed on behalf of somebody. And the one that fixed it is greater than the one that it is fixed for. It's women in it. So if the one that fixes or gives destiny is supreme, is higher, or is greater, whatever destiny he gives cannot be changed. Cannot be changed. And the only person that is supreme, greater, and higher in power, subject to no one and nothing, is God Almighty. So the destiny of everyone is the work or the work, the decision, the determination of God for that person or for that event, for that people, the crowd, the congregation, the country, you know, whatever it is. So, if destiny is the work of a supreme God, in this case, God Almighty, whom we call the God and the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, you cannot know true destiny, divine destiny outside of the knowledge of God's word. It's not possible. So for us to understand true destiny, or what destiny is all about, for you and I, we have to go back into God's word. Because the truth is this, what the church has borrowed as definition for destiny is what they were told by the world, what the world is defining as destiny. That's why if you go out now, not now anyway, on Friday night, you see everybody, so many crowd, doing night vigil. What are they doing? What are they looking for? They are praying that their destiny should be handed back to them. Because the world says, or the kingdom of darkness says, your destiny can be collected. Your destiny can be changed. If destiny can be collected or changed, then the one that gave the destiny is not supreme. And one of the things you and I must learn is this. God is not reactive. God is proactive. God does not react. Oh, something happened. Now God says, oh, look at, oh, what am I going to do? No, no, he doesn't react. The day God begins to react, he's no more God. So let's start with 2 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 15. Amanandete. See, they shock me as if I smoked something. We have to put this thing in perspective so that in the future Apostle Julius will not say, I've been preaching that thing before Papa, before I met Papa. This is very important. In 2 Timothy chapter 3 verse 15, 2 Timothy 3 15, 2 Timothy chapter 3 verse 15, everybody watch this, look at this, this is very important. People put 2 Timothy, I didn't say. All right, thank you. He said, you have been, chapter 3, verse 15. Paul is talking to Timothy. And that from a child, thou hast known the Holy Scriptures. That means before Timothy met Paul, he knew the Scriptures. And what Paul is referring to as Scripture is Genesis to Malachi. God punish ignorance. Am I making sense? What is he referring to as Scripture? Genesis to Malachi. So Timothy grew up knowing Genesis to Malachi, which are able to make thee wise. So what Genesis to Malachi is for is to sell out wisdom to you. Genesis to Malachi is not useful, but to give you wisdom, idea. Look at the wisdom it's supposed to give. Make thee wise unto salvation through faith, which is in Jesus Christ. So anytime you are reading Genesis to Malachi, the only good that is there in Malachi is to help you to know that you need a savior. Other than that, they are not useful. He said, Timothy, you know the scripture already, because that one is able to make you wise. And the wisdom it pretends or it gives or it displays is to lead you to salvation that is in Christ Jesus. So whatever you are reading in the Old Testament, if it does not lead you to Jesus Christ, you are not reading correctly. Watch you. So, you can't understand divine knowledge, divine fruit, divine destiny outside of the scripture and what the scripture is pointing to, which is salvation in Christ. Am I making sense? Thank you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. Bada. Let me show you a couple of more before I run along. In 1 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 21, NIV translation. 1 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 21. 1 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 21, NIV translation. Everybody watch this. Thank you, precious Father. Because I want to show you that we cannot learn about destiny, divine destiny, outside of the truth of God's word. You can't go and borrow things from, you can't even read dictionary to define destiny. Dictionary did not fall from sky. Somebody wrote it. A group of people came together and wrote it. And the people who came together and wrote it did not understand destiny according to God. For since in the wisdom of God, 1 Corinthians chapter 1 verse 21, since in the wisdom of God, the world through wisdom did not know God. So God decided to use, God played his own wisdom. What was God's wisdom? His wisdom is that no human being will, by human wisdom, know anything about God. That's why you can't go to university to learn about God. God came out with wisdom to block intellectual wisdom from anybody using intellectual wisdom to know him. God came up with a wisdom to block it, to block human. So the greatest professor of the world does not know God. He can never know God. He said God was pleased through the foolishness of what was preached to save those who believe. Still wait. Let me still show you one more. For you to know that it is a crime, a sin, an abomination, an injustice to God and yourself to define destiny according to the world. In Ephesians chapter 1, verse 1 to 6, the Message translation. Ephesians 1. You know, I prayed for you and I'm believing that the Lord will give you understanding. But if I follow my mind, it's like my mind is saying, no. These people may not get it. But I trust God. Ephesians chapter 2, from verse 1 to 6, the Message translation. Watch this. Everyone, look. If you're writing right quickly, let's read it together. Ephesians chapter 2, verse 1. It wasn't so long ago that you were made in that old, stagnant life of sin. That means before we became born again, there was a life we were living. That life was restricted, stupid, governed by the forces and blindness of darkness. But watch, verse 2. Thank you, Lord Jesus. You let the world, you allow the world, which does not know the first thing about living. To tell you, the word tell means to define. To define to you how to live. The world that does not even know God at all, you are turning to them. Because before, that's what we used to do. Before we became born again, we used to go to the world. Anything we want to learn, we'll go to the world. It's the world that taught us. That's why we went to primary school, secondary school, university. Am I making sense? Do you know there are some sicknesses and diseases that no matter how bad the thing is, if you just wait on the Spirit of God, it can give you just one idea of what to do. And then that sickness will die. But we keep going to the world to acquire knowledge in relating with God. He said we were so stupid that time. So you can't go to the world to ask for destiny. But the world cannot give you what they don't have. 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verses 12 to 14, NIV translation. Let me see, settle you for you to know why we do not accept, believe in the destiny the world is teaching. Why we have to go to God through his word to learn the right or the truth of destiny. In 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 12 to 14, NIV translation. Look at this. 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 12. He said, we have not received the spirit of the world. You see, but the spirit, which is from who now? Talk to me. The spirit we have is from who? It's from God. That we may understand what God has freely given to us. Open it. So what the world cannot teach us, the Spirit of God, through the scripture, teach us those things. You know, these things should be for Bible school. But through me, the Lord is about to invade the earth on a higher dimension of truth. Look at the next verse. Verse 13. Watch. This is what we speak. We don't speak what the world is teaching. We speak what the Spirit of God, through the knowledge of the Word of God, teach us. That's what we speak. Not in words taught by human wisdom, but in words taught by the Spirit, expressing spiritual truth in spiritual words. Hallelujah! Verse 14. A man without the Spirit does not accept the things that come from the Spirit of God. For they are foolishness to him, and he cannot understand them, because they are spiritually understood. So when we talk about destiny, professors from Harvard are rendered incompetent. Professors from Harvard, when we talk of divine destiny, we render the knowledge and the wisdom of professors from Harvard useless. We sit them down to teach them what destiny is. No man born of a woman was ever born with destiny. Nobody. No man born of a woman was ever born with destiny. Chica, right. You can't cram these things. Right. You see, if your preaching is, God will do it for you, receive it now, this teaching will not make sense to you. Because you are a babe. See, but the time is coming, people will challenge you about destiny. The knowledge is going spreading now on the internet. Any minister that is not giving his or herself to knowledge will be abused very soon. And you know, abuse is going on already. Abuse is going on already. That book is dead. No man born of a woman has ever a destiny. No man. There's only one man. And his name is Jesus. But I'm still coming to that. It's a serious matter. That book, I refuse to buy it. They were angry with me that time. I said, this book is not, you bought the book. How many of you bought that book? I kept telling them there's something wrong. This book is not of God. I said, Papa, everything. I said, it's not a matter of everything. This book is not of God. The writer himself, the author, came out to apologize now. He came to repent. Another person is protecting him before. The writer, author, he came out to say he's sorry. Because in the book, he's describing God. He said, God is nine. There are nine gods. What are you talking about? They use sweet mouth. They gainsay. Flattery. Just to sell books. The same thing with Miracle Meal. I never read that book. Because when I saw the team, I said, it's not of God. That's why I'm saying, if you do not give yourself to learning, and the learning must be the knowledge of Jesus Christ, deception is going to be very easy for the person to enter into. Look at the wave of the rush. Everybody rushing. What are they rushing to? What kinds of ungodly things? But there are some of us that have decided that we are going to hold on to the head, which is Jesus Christ. There are no succuba. No man born has ever had a destiny. Only one man. And his name is Jesus. Jesus is the only one as a human being that entered the world having a destiny. Now, if you do not understand my definition of destiny, this thing I'm saying now will be a struggle for you. It will be a struggle. Destiny is a fixed future or event that is unchangeable. The only person that has a destiny that could not be changed was Jesus. Wait, okay, 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 watch this now. Okay, okay, watch this. No, watch it. Okay, watch this. He said, when he cometh into the world, he said, when he cometh into the world, he said, a body you have prepared for me. That for one reason, that I might do your will. Now, watch, what is his will? That I may give my life as a ransom for many. That's what he said. He came knowing why he came. He was destined to be a savior. Remember in Luke chapter 2 verse 11, he said unto us, a child is born. He's not born as a child to just go and roam about the street. He was born a savior. Destiny. Fixed destiny. By one that is superior. Watch. Now, where are all the devils of this world? Where are the witches and wizards? Where are all the marine spirits? Power must change hands, spirit. Where were they when he announced that I came to do your will, as it is written? Yet they couldn't change it. So he himself, Arana Toka, knowing that the powers of darkness could not change it, he went to the one that gave him the destiny. He said, "Can we change his destiny?" Is it possible that this cup passed over me? I'm not sure that's destiny changing. The one that fixed it says it's not possible. I won't change it. And because I do not change it, he said, the God of this world could not change it. Because if they had known, they would not have crucified. It's his fixed destiny. They must crucify him. It's a fixed destiny. All the powers of darkness could not cancel this destiny. He even went, said, Father, is it possible? Let's just change this thing. He said, no. I change it not. And because the Father refused to change it, no power of hell could change it. What you are born to do, no devil can change it. It's not a prayer. It's not a prayer. You must know it yourself. Am I talking to somebody here? Let your father's second wife go and do any juju somewhere. If I was born for it, I will fulfill it. He said, I lay in Zion a stone. I lay it in Zion. I didn't say I ask you to come and join me to lay this stone. He said, I lay in Zion a stone. And this stone, I lay it as a foundation. Foundation, foundation. And you know that the foundation of God started sure. It can't be changed. You didn't hear what I said. I thought somebody is hearing what I'm talking. I said it cannot be changed. It is an error, a sin, a disservice to God. So pray that, oh God, change my destiny. Anywhere they bury my destiny, let my destiny come out. Ah! It's an abomination. Abomination. It was too heavy. He is praying. The devil, the forces of hell, they were hearing. He doesn't want this destiny. He's hoping that this destiny should change. Yet they couldn't change it. Because the one that gave it is superior. He said, this is what must happen. This is what I have determined for you. Fixed. Fixed. Sit down, let's walk this thing. I'm about to enter into some dangerous thing. One of the first things that confuses ministers and Christians about destiny, anytime they are preaching about destiny, and they go to borrow the idea that the world suggests, teaches is that they go into the Old Testament characters of the Bible. They take their activities, their failures, their successes, mix it with the happenings around them, and begin to suggest, whether positively or negatively, the things concerning them as their destiny. Don't worry, I know it's too much. Go and listen to it. What I said again, you will hear it. Samson Alagbara eventually caught Samson, shave his head, remove his eyes. What of Saul? Samuel said, wait, let me go yonder and ask God. I will come back. Before Samuel came back, he offered the sacrifice. He said, this day, this thing is collected from you and given to your neighbor. He said, that's destiny. He lost his destiny. That is no destiny. You have not understood yet that the Most High ruled over the affairs. That's not destiny. Over the affairs. He still influences men. It's not a destiny. Now, somebody will now ask me, how do I know that? That's why he gave us the Holy Spirit. If your destiny is fixed, you don't need Holy Spirit. Whether Holy Spirit is there or not, what is fixed is fixed. You see, my house is there. I don't need Holy Spirit for my house to be there when I get there. I don't understand. You see, my house, where you came from, your house, it's fixed. You need Holy Ghost to help you. Make sure your house will be there when you come. No, it's there. It's fixed. The reason he gave us the Holy Spirit is because the issues of your life, they are not destiny. That's why the Holy Ghost must help you to navigate. He knows where your victory is. You see, you must not confuse your destiny with your place of function in the body of Christ. I'm going to say that again. You must not confuse your destiny with your place of function. You see, Christ is a whole body. W-H-O-L-E. Whole body. Amen. And it is all of us, not just all of us here, all over the world, Christians all over the world, all of us make up the whole of the body of Christ. Am I making sense? Now, all of us together make the whole complete body. But that all of us are individuals of us. You, me, you, you. You, do you understand? Huh. Our destiny is Jesus Christ. In Christ, we have different functions. So people are confusing their place of function in the body as destiny. You see, if you look at Apostle Roxon like this, I'm afraid that's the whole of Apostle Roxon. But he has two hands, two legs. Now, the hand is not his destiny. The hand, he must understand what the purpose of the hand. The hand is to help him. See, he's holding his phone. He can't hold his phone with his leg. He's holding it with his hand. Hand holding phone is not a destiny. It's a function. I'm trying to beat time, that's why. In 1 Corinthians chapter 12, he said, though we be many members, yet we are individuals. individual members in particular. One. Now, that one of us, Paul said in 1 Corinthians 12, he said, God has placed each of us in the body as he pleases him. That means where we are to function, God put us. Some of us are supposed to function as servant to other people in the body of Christ. He doesn't make us slaves. That is just where he puts us. So nobody is destined to be a slave. It's just your functional place. Okay, let me put it this way. Nobody is destined to be rich. It's my destiny. I must be rich. I must buy aircraft. I must buy Rolls Royce. It's my destiny. I must build estate. Something is wrong with you. Where did you get that from? What kind of a destiny? What kind of a stupid destiny is that? You see, your destiny. We went to borrow what the world called destiny, because the devil taught the world. The devil taught the world about destiny. Church is going to the world to go and borrow what the devil taught the world, destiny as destiny. Nobody is destined to be rich. Otherwise, there will be other people destined to be poor. And if God destined you to be rich and destined others to be poor, then there is variableness with God. You see that God is not reliable. And we can't call him our God. But Jesus came and explained to us in Luke chapter 6. He allows his rain to fall both on the just and the unjust. He allows his sun to rise both on the wicked, the evildoer, and the person that says, thank you, God, and the person that says, I don't care about God. So God does not give destiny for anybody to be rich. Neither does he give destiny for anybody to be poor. When God created, you see, God existed without anything. When God created the world, the universe, not just this world, not just the earth. You understand? When God created the universe, after he finished creating, the Bible said on the seventh day, he rested. Now the question is, why did God have to rest? Why? This is how you understand the difference between destiny and function. Why did God have to rest? Some people think that God came to rest because it's Sabbath. Get out of town. Some say, okay, God went to rest because God has finished whatever is created. Okay, what if what God created went out of joint? Wouldn't you go and walk again? God rested because everything God created, he created a principle of their self-sustaining function. The dog in my house was born by the previous dog that I had. That one don't all die. So this one, two, don't born. Had puppies. The puppies are grown. Do you understand what I'm saying? Let me ask you, who taught those dogs how to sleep with each other? You see, when God created everything, he set a principle in them. He set an awareness into everything that they should self be sustained. It is when that self-sustainer falls out of place that we cry out to God to help put it back. That's what we call miracle. That's why he doesn't want you to live by miracle. Just understand what to do. This will happen. If God gave you a job, don't abuse your oga. Otherwise, you will lose the job. Then you now cry to God to help you get a job. Why do you need to cry to God? Because you lost the job, you misbehaved. That's why you are crying to him to help you get a job. If you didn't misbehave, do you have to cry to him? No. Everything, God set everything in place. take care of, to just keep rolling. That's why he decided to rest after creating everything. He now set in motion a evolving, sustaining principle for everything. Tonight we are doing miracle service. Fruit of the womb, miracle service. That's rubbish. That's nonsense. What is miracle? What fruit of the womb, miracle service? If an arm robber catches a girl on the road and she's ovulating, if he sleeps with that girl and ejaculates into that girl, she will become pregnant. If she is not pregnant, it is not the, your own destiny that you should have a child. No, it's a mental issue. There's nothing wrong with the person. The way we have made up, they have made us to think, believe, to condition our mind, is to give so much power to the kingdom of darkness that even the devil himself is amazed. The devil is wondering, so I get this kind of power. Boys, I didn't know. Father, this year, make me rich. This year, make me rich. This year, make me rich. Can't you see that's why you are poor? It doesn't make anybody rich. If God makes people rich, look, the whole world will have become born again. Because they will see the way Christians are just rich. Rich. Because we can pray to be rich. To be rich is not a destiny. So he gave us the spirit. If God is going to use somebody to help you, the spirit of God begin to nudge you. Patient. Don't talk anyhow. Or you don't know who is around. And God may want to use to help you. The person now he sees. Oh, no. That person talks too much. I don't like that. Even from my village, they're trying to change my destiny. They are pressing. I know my destiny. Help! My destiny has helping grace. But the people of my village, they're not allowing my destiny to shine. God said, get out of here. I'm leading you into how to be helped. He said, no. He led them out of Egypt by themselves in the wilderness. He said, they want to go back to Egypt. He was anyway. Is it not in Egypt you are crying out to me that you want to come out? Okay, I'm bringing you out now. I'm taking you to a place called Canaan, where everything is set. You are still saying you want to go back to Egypt. What kind of people are this one? I don't understand. If you don't learn to allow the fruit of the Spirit to flow through you, the devil will keep telling you something is wrong with your destiny. If you do not learn to allow fruit of the Spirit to flow through you, the devil will suggest to you, he will teach you to think and to believe that something is wrong with your destiny. Somebody is holding your destiny. You know, Jonah, what somebody would think now is that, how can just the fruit of the Spirit be what? Just all that I need. The Bible said, against such, there is no law. That means if all the demons and witches and wizards, if they combine together, they don't have anything to hold you with. Against such, there is no law. Against such, there's no law. Galatians 5, help me out. Galatians chapter 5, verse 22 to 23. Let's read again. Let me show you. the destiny. Don't tell anybody they are burying your destiny. Don't let it come out of your mouth. They can't. Don't stop that. Amen. Watch this. But the fruit of the Spirit is what? Now remember, the reason you are giving the Spirit is to lead you. So as he's leading you, he said, look, this is the fruit of the Spirit. As the Spirit is leading you, allow yourself to walk in love. Be joyful. Nobody wants sad person around them. This one is always sad. But anytime, woo, glory be to God. Everybody will gravitate towards you. So this destiny you think they are burying, just be joyful and see. See solution, no? Without going to Rio. Isaiah said, you shall go out with joy. It's, no matter what happens, when it comes to your turn, go out with joy. Because the Spirit is the one that is supposed to lead you. So the fruit of the Spirit is joy. The fruit of the Spirit is peace. So the word of God says, pursue after peace. Look, do anything to make for peace. Don't do. And so what? So that's why nobody will help you. And then you now say they are burying your destiny. Who's burying what? It's pursue peace, long suffering, gentleness, goodness, faith. Watch. Next verse, verse 23. Quickly. Verse 23. Load me with it. Meekness, temperance. Against such. Against such. There is no word. No law. No juju. No juju can hold you. If you are hedged up on every side and it looks as if you are shaking to free yourself and it's not, check. Are you surrendering to the fruit of the Spirit? I don't agree. You will soon feel like they bury your destiny. You feel it? Because against this one, it's no law. I remember we went to the elders meeting. I was sitting down by the door. James, just give me a knock on the head. Go. At my age. I said, thank you, sir. Don't mess up. Against such. I would have said, never. Don't ever try that. Say, and I mean disgrace like this. You can't see that there is a law. That. Against such, there is no law. Forget all this destiny, cover your destiny. God, that's why you see that the Christians in Nigeria, they are suffering more than Muslims. And the reason is because they are very stupid. I'm not abusing them, I'm saying the state of their condition. Stupid people. Go back to verse 22 again. Go back to verse 22. Jesus. But the fruit of the Spirit is love. Love. Let it ooze out of you everywhere. Every time. Are you there? They shoot arrow. Hello, shooting arrow. Every arrow. Wherever you're coming from. Every. God said there is a realm against such. There's no law. Thank you. where you are, let there be joy against such. That's how you enter. There are all manner of laws in that place. The law of avoid that person is in that place. The law of don't ever say hello to that person is in that place. The law of don't give that person what you have is in that place. But when you enter, hello, I love you all, God bless you, against such, there is no law. To exit suffering is very easy. It's the easiest. If you are struggling and you are suffering. Because it's not a destiny. It's not a destiny. Struggling and suffering is not a destiny. Look. There's a realm you get into through knowledge and submitting to the fruit of the Spirit. Against such, there's no law. Nobody's called to suffer. It didn't say you should endure suffering. It said endure hardness. Hardness means opposition. When they say it's a lie, it's like what you are preaching is a lie. That man is not a man of God. It said endure that one. It didn't say you should endure no money, no cash. When you get to a certain age, you stop having enemies. Start developing relationships. Otherwise, you are heading towards loneliness. Loneliness will become the person's rapper. Got to a point, Jesus had to advise himself. He advised himself. No matter how I talk, everybody's offended outside. Jesus is 12. You always explain to them. Otherwise, you will end up a lonely man on the cross. When he's talking to the people, the general public, complicated parables, a good verse come out. He got to a point from the age of 32, remaining one more year. Once he finished talking to them, he will call these guys. Remember that parable I was telling them? This is the parable. Let me explain it. He will tell them. That's why they were with him in the last minute. Who do you see? Jesus. It's because there were others with him and they look like him. I don't need anybody. I don't need anybody. Oh, Timon, come. The devil will soon tell you they buried your destiny. He said, woe to him that is alone. For when he is cold, he has not warming up. Not warming. No, who is your husband and wife? Who is your husband and wife? Don't confuse destiny for your place of function. We started at our destiny. Every man that is born again started at his destiny. Our destiny is Jesus. While I lay in Zion, it's to watch you. Jonah, watch. Let me show you this aspect. Consider. I'll show you this aspect. Ezekiel, right. I want to show Jonah an aspect. I lay in Zion a stone, a foundation. Because that stone, the foundation of Zion, anything outside of that foundation is not guaranteed. The thing is not fixed. the foundation of God standeth sure. And there's a seal on it. For other foundation can no man lay other than that which is laid. So if things are falling, it's because the person is not on that foundation. So if the person is on that foundation, things can't fall apart. Because Jesus is that foundation. Jesus is the destiny of everybody. It's everybody's destiny. Am I making sense here? But watch this. Yes. Thank you. This is the place I want to show this abong. Like Richard too wants to get it. But this man is a very wise man. He's trying to. I want to offload it. Then he should steal out of it. When it was 8 days, according to the tradition of the Jews, they carried baby Jesus into the temple for dedication. The Bible said there was a man blind there, a prophet. And God said he will not die until he has seen the Messiah. As soon as they brought the baby in, the Holy Ghost said to Simeon, what I said you should wait for before you exit the earth has entered. Simeon went straight to Mary, took the baby from Mary. He said, Mary, around there, Holy Ghost came on Simeon. And he began to declare to Mary. He said, Mary, you don't know what you have in your hand. This baby is the reason for the rise and the fall of many people. He said, this child is the reason so many people will fall. And this child is the reason so many people will rise. Agadayada, the foundation of God standeth sure, having this seal. This child is the destiny of so many. Anybody who accepts this child as their Lord and Savior, they come into a stable life. A stable life. The Holy Ghost just energized my spirit. This child is the reason many, many will succeed in life. This child is the reason many will become complete in life. This child is the reason that the powers of darkness will not be able to hold down anybody. This child is the reason it will be said that greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. This child is going to be the reason for the freedom of mankind. This child is going to be the reason. I feel like coming out of my body. So Tagaya, my spirit want to jump out of my body. This child is the reason life will be subdued, death will be overcome. This child is the reason hell cannot drag a man. And brother Dosatori and Grato Sapara. Eleta Osato Hazaza. Azarata Itakuri and Antekria. This child. I'm telling you, can you feel this thing here? Something is broken loose in the realm of the spirit. This child. This child. In Jesus' name. See that, let me finish this thing. See, we have not even called for prayer. The Holy Ghost is quickening our spirit. It's not you that is praying, no. It's the Holy Ghost giving utterance to your spirit. Your spirit is energized. Because your spirit recognizes the truth. So the truth of the Holy Ghost is entering and is entering God's spirit. Our spirit is communicating with the Holy Ghost all manner of things. I Wherever you're watching me, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, whatever the devil has done or is doing, I curse that devil in the name of Jesus. I command your body to be healed. Be delivered from the shackles of evil. Ah, something is turned loose here. I'm telling you, let him that was and is and forever shall be, let him be glorified in the church. Woo! Every door that looks shut, let it be open now. In Jesus' name. Sit down. My. Bless you. Let's start from there. Luke chapter 2, verse 34. NIV. Luke chapter 2, verse 34. NIV translation. Woo! Glory be to God. Luke, not Leviticus. Luke chapter 2, verse 34. NIV translation. And Simeon. Then Simeon blessed them and said to Mary, is the mother of the baby, this child is destined. Roxy, see destiny. This child is what? Destined to cause the falling and the rising of many. Destiny is not that you have bought a car. Muslim buy a car. But this child is the reason Muslims are falling. It is as many as receive him. To them he gave power. They become. Why is this child the destiny of either rising or falling? Toby. Ask me. Run out. Ask me, sharp. Why is this child the reason for the fall and rise? Destiny for the fall and rise of many. That means this child is the only destiny that will make anybody fall. And is the only destiny that will make anybody rise. The devil can't make anybody fall. That's why I said, even if a man falls, he is unto his master. Yeah, the master didn't say he has fallen. So that's why I say he should leave you. So David said he upholded him with his right hand. That's why you can't say a man has fallen. You don't understand. You look at someone and say, this man has fallen. The Bible says whether he standard or fallen is unto his master. So what's the use? David said by the Spirit in the psalm, he said, for even though he fallen, his master upholded him. So the master has not said he has fallen. Is the person holding somebody that can say the person has fallen? Simeon said, Mary, wait. See destiny. He said, see destiny. Did you not make me fall? Pray and fasting, now you make me stand. He said, the falling of anybody. So how can you say you are falling? How can you say they have buried your destiny? They've buried your glory. They have tampered with you. How now? Julius is looking at me like I fell from sky. He's wondering what kind of a man is this? Now, the question we should ask is what Toby asked. Why is it that this child is the destiny both for falling and for rising? Let me show you. Shoot me with NLT translation of Ephesians chapter 1 verse 9. Ephesians chapter 1 verse 9. NLT translation. Shoot me with it. What are you talking about? This is an old translation of NLT. This one is an old translation. There's a newer translation. So this old one, let's read this old one first. God has now revealed to us his mysterious plan regarding Christ. A plan to fulfill his own good pleasure. See, this one is like a summary. Just summarize it. It didn't give the full embodiment. Let me give you the same NLT, the full embodiment. Everybody listen to it. Except if you have it. You have it. All right, read it.
God's secret plan has now been revealed to us. It is a plan centered on Christ. Yes, sir. Centered on Christ. Designed long ago according to his own good pleasure.
So God said, this is my plan. All my plan. Everything that is going to become my plan. Anything anybody will call my plan. God said, this is it. Jesus, stand up. Jesus said, yeah, that's my plan. He pointed to Jesus and said, this is my plan. He said, you and I were looking for how Israel should kill the Amalekite. God said, this is my plan. Wait now. I'm coming. So this plan, that's why this child is the destiny of both rising and falling. Anybody has to fall and this child. Anybody has to rise and this child. People need to upgrade this, your NLT. You have to upgrade it to a newer version. So why is Jesus? Why is it that all of God's plan is centered on Jesus? Why? Watch this. In 2 Timothy chapter 1 verse 9. 2 Timothy chapter 1 verse 9 in the King James Version. 2 Timothy chapter 1 verse 9. Hey, man of God needs to drink water while alive. Thank you, Lord Jesus. 2 Timothy chapter 1 verse 9. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Are you seeing it? He said, God had saved us. Come on now. God had done what? No, talk to me like you believe it. God has done what? Saved us. He saved us. And called us with an holy calling. Just open it up. Mike doesn't know when. Catch the flow. God saved us. After saving us, he now called us with an holy calling. See what happened? That's why this child is his destiny for rising and falling. God saved us and called us with an holy calling. You see, if you read this thing like this, it looks like, come on, be born again. Look at that one, he's sleeping. After that, he will blame his uncle. That his uncle is the reason he's not progressing. Or he will blame his father. I put in labor into this thing. Who had saved us and called us with an holy calling. Now, if you look at this, just that who has saved us and called us with an holy calling and stop there, The first thing that you would think is, God just say, okay, come on, come on, born again, go and get born again. You are born again, thank you. You too, you are born again. No, no, no. That's not what he's talking about. Because in context, he now said, not according to our works, but according to his own purpose. That means our salvation and calling in Christ Jesus is our state of being. It's not changeable. Cannot be changed. Why is it that it cannot be changed? According to his own purpose and grace, which was given to us where? In Christ Jesus, before the world began. God decided that there are people that will be born again. These people, when they become born again, I will make them in Christ permanently. Their works has nothing to do with it. Hey. So, why is it that Christians are falling? Oh. Why is it that Christians are falling? Why are they stranded? Why? Oh God, open this door for me. They've been praying open door since last week. Since last year. Since 2 years ago. Open door. Open door. Why? Remember, this child is the reason for rising and falling. Jesus as a destiny, it's our state of being. It cannot be added to, cannot be subtracted. But then, the Holy Ghost now came to Paul and elaborated on this thing. That he that believeth shall not be ashamed. So if you are in him, a sure place of destiny, and you are still struggling, check your believing. You know what we do? We worry. Come out. Enter worry again. Come out. We enter worry again. Come out. Remember, without faith, it is impossible to engage God. To engage God. Can't engage you. So it's not that somebody has buried your destiny. He said this child is the reason for the fall of anybody and the rise of anybody, including Christian. If you want things to be hard for you, keep and don't believe. Whether Peter is going to walk on water or he's going to sink, it's where his faith. Don't hear me. Whether Peter will walk on water or he will sink is where his faith is. We declare night vigil. Come for night vigil. Anywhere you bury, your destiny must be open. And you now came for the night vigil. You must fall. You don't believe that this destiny is unchangeable. And what you don't believe, he said, because of that child, the person will fall. You
Emily, just bring the thing. I bless my homies.
Let all the witches of this world gather on this road. In 2 weeks, I will still do fellowship. They can't stop. No, they can't stop. They're going to. They don't want. The reason our church is not growing is the witches and wizards in that area. Get out of town. You must fall. Because you are forgotten. That you are in a sure place. Fixed destiny. And he that giveth the increase is God. Not witches and wizards. Why are we praying to witches and wizards? They don't want my church to grow. They want, so witches and wizards, they're going to hold your life now. So they are your destiny now. He said one plant, another one water. The one that giveth the increase is God. Keep faith in that child. You will keep rising. I'm telling you, see those pimples all over my body. Something is tongue loose in my spirit. Look, let me tell you. Let me tell you. Everybody, hear me. Nobody had destiny in the Old Testament. Before you, your mother born you, I formed you. Before you were formed, I knew you. That's hogwash. Is that not in Jeremiah? Jeremiah chapter 1. Ebenezer asked me that question. Just remember that. Let me branch there and flock it. Let me open his eyes in that area. If nobody has destiny, sir, which is a good question. What of Jeremiah? Before I formed thee, I knew you. You want to boast now? You told him to ask. Say, I want to take the glory. So what happened to Jeremiah? Is that not a destiny? Don't confuse assignment for destiny. Even Enoch, he did not die. He was whisked away. Is that a destiny? Let's ask Jonah. Enoch. He walked with God and was not. Is that a destiny? Elijah, chariot of fire. Is that a destiny? Let me shock you. Is it here? With all your book, as our professor, let me shock you. In Hebrews 11, the Bible says, all of them, they died. All of them died. That's to tell you, Enoch, he got die somewhere. Because Toby will be boasting. God took Enoch. And it was not. Let's show Toby. Put Hebrews 11. Hebrews 11. They are all of them. All of them. All of them. Hebrews 11. Look for it for me. Verse 29. Hebrews 11. Richard, are you seeing Bible? It's a serious matter. What are you talking about? Well, they are joining. They all died. All these died. All these. T-H-E-S-E. All these. You know, hurry up now. It's there now. Hebrews 11:13. God bless you. Put Hebrews 11:13. I'll punish them. Everybody, look at. Look at this. It's here now. I want to use that to call your attention. Look at it. It started with Enoch. Look for Enoch verse. Look for Enoch verse. Let's start for you. We'll come back to verse 13. Look for Enoch verse.
Look for Enoch. Verse 5. Put verse 5 first. Hebrews 11:5. Put verse 5. Put verse 5. By faith, Enoch was translated that he should not what? See death. And was not found. Because God had translated him. Go to verse 13. Verse 13. How many of them? Including Jeremiah. Before I formed you. There's only one person that didn't die. Yeah! Nobody killed him. On the cross, he gave up the ghost. Because it was a destiny. All of them, they went to die somewhere. They went somewhere. Let me tell you. I was born an apostle of Jesus Christ. That is not my destiny. It is my place of function in the body of Christ. You are a pastor. It's not your destiny. It's your place of function. As someone says, Papa, how do you know? Very simple. Yeah. Sure. But ask me, Papa, how do you know? Ask me, how did you know? Ask me. In Acts chapter 20, just while Paul was getting ready to die, he wrote to the church at Ephesus, telling all the pastors, remember, it's Holy Spirit that made you overseer over the flock. It's not your destiny. Among all of Paul, you could just say, Jonah, come and help me oversee what feast. What feast? Now you can't give a word feast. Only which kind of God? If the name of your church is not working, change it. Don't say it's my destiny. Which stupid destiny? There's a man of God in Ibadan. For 12 years, they were battling in his church. They refused to be up to 10. 12 years. It was war. Battle. Finally, on the 11th year, got tired. He couldn't feed his wife, couldn't feed himself, couldn't feed his children. They sent him out of school. He said that Jesus disappointed him. He got angry with Jesus. He got angry. Now went somewhere that he's going to pray. Anybody? This man said, as he entered the room, just locked himself to start praying. Jesus said, welcome. See, I've been looking for you. Me, myself, I've been looking for you. See, to come, see, you know, Greek up. Does it go? See, that's why all those battles. You see, Jesus said, first of all, before we start, what's the name of your church? You see, those congregations, the Holy Ghost appointed you to oversee. Which name did you give that gathering? You know his name? Battlefield Ministries. He said the Lord told him all the forces of darkness. Anytime they want to fight, he said, you don't die because you have pronounced it in the realm of the spirit for them. He said, they come there for the battle. He said, so how in the spirit will people come and gather in that place? He said, change the name of your ministry. The Lord didn't give him a name. He said, change it. Change it yourself. Change it. He said, no wonder. When somebody comes, they will fight each other. They don't go. Another will come out of evangelism or prayer or fasting. Another will come, they will fight. They will go again. He's fed up. 10, 11, 12 years. Before the Lord said, what is the name of your ministry?
Some born again Christians, we call themselves battle axe. I am God's battle axe or the mumu. Who made you his battle axe? They go beat you tire. The owner, come to me, all you that labor, and a heavy lady, and I will give you rent. He said you want to be back to us.
All right.
He said, who gave his rent to the robber? And who gave out to be afflicted? He said, but none said restore. He said she's hedging on every side as though burnt with fire. Yet nobody says restore. But instead, they were ready to fight. He said then the Lord gave them strength for battle. As they fight, they go. Once you start fighting, you should check yourself. Are you allowing the fruit of the Spirit? I need to do part 3 of this thing again. Because in Ephesians chapter 1 verse 3, it says, blessed be the God and the Father of our Lord Jesus, who had blessed us with how many? All spiritual blessings. That's our destiny. Our destiny is that we are a blessed people. The rise and fall of many is because of this child. Thank you, Lord Jesus. When God brings you into Jesus Christ as your destiny, relax. You are in a sure place. Help me tell somebody I'm in a sure place. No, help me tell somebody, say I'm in a sure place. No matter the evil that is blowing any wind against you and I, we are blessed with all spiritual blessings. I say you are blessed with all spiritual blessings. You are blessed with all spiritual blessings. You are blessed with all spiritual blessings. It's our destiny. It cannot be programmed. And I'll give you 2 scriptures before I get out of here. Can I just offload 2 for you? Let me show you the first one. In NIV. Isaiah 46 verse 9 and 10. NIV, Isaiah chapter 46, verses 9 and 10. NIV. Isaiah 46, verses 9 and 10. Remember the former things. Hallelujah. Those of long ago. See who he's talking to? Not desire to introduce himself. I am God. I'm not trying to be God. I'm not assisting God. I am God. The person talking is introducing himself. Watch. What's the implication of the introduction? There is no other. I am God, and there is none like me. Number one, I am God. There is no other God. Nobody can call himself God. So all those things making us in your village, they are not God. So if they are not God, they are not responsible for your destiny. And if they are not responsible for your destiny, they can't overturn your destiny. Bless with all spiritual blessings. Number 2. I am God, there is none like me. They can't fix things the way I fix it.
But Apostle Ezekiel, this is the part that touched me. Verse 10. I make known the end from the beginning. So if I say this thing will end here, let your father's second wife let them come and fight it. They can't push it. I am God. There's no other like me. I make known the end from the voice that now, the word the beginning is not correct. It's when it is yet to appear. Before it starts at all, I say this is the end of so. Yes. From ancient times, what is to come? I say, my purpose, it will stand. My purpose will stand. And I will do how many? All! Everything that I have decided. Aradaga soteria. Is somebody getting this in here? Now, with this understanding, I want you to lock it into Isaiah chapter 8, verse 10. Knowledge. Devise your strategy. It will be thwarted. Propose your plan. It will not stand. For God is with us. What are you talking about? Put it in King James. You are Pastor J. Put it in King James. Take counsel together. Please, let all the witches in Lagos and Akonjo go and gather together. Together, and it shall. It will. That means it will not happen. It will not happen. Speak the word. It shall not stand. God is with us. See, by growth and by grace, or by grace and by growth. I have passed some things. Can never be stranded in life. No. I don't do God. Let me not be stranded in account. It's not possible. By grace and growth. Grace and growth. It may not appear the way you expect it, but I cannot be stranded. By grace and growth. It will be an injustice to God for me to start praying, oh God, don't let them tie me down like this. No. God will excuse me to pray that prayer when I got born again newly. But if I pray it now, it will not be pleased. Blessed be the God and the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who had blessed us with how many? All. And that God introduced himself. I am God. There's no other. I am God. There's none like me. I will do my counsel. My purpose shall stand. And he said, oh yeah, you say your own. We will now say, take counsel together.
yala kori koba yala yai. All of you gather. What are you talking about?
Agarana no no ya so. You also very some people start preaching this destiny.
So when we come out, when we come out. Even if the head of Satan is at Three Junction Road, we head of Satan, only issue, Lodi Tabeta, we are not even going for him. We are just on our own. As he sees us coming, he has to advise himself to step aside. Otherwise, his head will burst into pieces. Am I making sense here? Paul said there is not this knowledge in every man, but this knowledge is in us. That there is no God anywhere else. There's no other God. Every other thing is camouflage. They are fake, trying to pretend to be like God. But we know that there is only one God, and that God has blessed us with all spiritual blessings. You need to talk to your body. Tell your body, keep quiet and respond to healing. God has blessed me with healing. He has blessed my mind. He has blessed my finances. He has blessed my body. With this knowledge, with this understanding, talk to yourself. This God that is greater than every other God has blessed me with all blessings. I command what look as if is not in place to enter and fall into place in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. By the power that raised the Lord Jesus from the dead, I declare that my mind is sound, my body is healed. I have the wisdom of God. I know what to do. I am thinking straight. I am thinking where. Everybody stand to your feet. Go for it, everybody. Go for it. Go for it. Bless with all spiritual blessings. Bless with all spiritual blessings. Bless with all spiritual blessings. Bless with all bless with all spiritual blessings. Who is it that said the thing and it cometh to pass when the mouth of the Lord has not said it? Take counsel together, you foul spirit. It will not stand. It will not stand. Your counsel will not stand. Speak the word. It will not come to pass. You enemies, you wicked powers of darkness. Will not come to pass, but the Lord God is with us. The Lord God is with us. This fellowship is growing in leaps and bounds. Yay! Our little is 1,000 in the name of Jesus. Barata keso toria da gasota. Esuriana nante keto asante reke turia gasa tabra ebra de katuria krete koso toronte. Yay! I'm telling you, listen here. I release your heavens. I release everything that has to do with you. Every good thing. I command it for your sake. I release you by the power that raised Christ from the dead. And I decree and declare your ways are open. All things now are working for your good. I send you in the name of Jesus. Go!
You are blessed with all spiritual blessings. I command the war against you to cease. I curse the wicked one. The war against you cease. The war against you cease. Satan, leave Roxanne. He's my son. Roxanne is my son. He's my son. He's my son. Command the war against you to cease. Roxanne, go free. You are my son. I'm telling you, this thing is upon me. Pray in the spirit, everybody. Pray in the spirit. Every devil mobilized against you in the name of the Lord Jesus. I curse them with the root. Whatever name they have, whatever name they are called, I curse them with the root. I curse them with the root. I curse it with the root. Every devil, every demonic assignment, every planting that is not of God, I curse them with the root. I curse it with the root. Be uprooted with the root. In the name of Jesus, with the root, with the root. With the root. Shananiya. Command the war against you to cease. Yeah, I command the war against you to cease. It is a bridge, yet it is not broken. Go over it. Go over it. The bridge is yours. The bridge is yours for good. Go over it, saith the Lord. It's a bridge. It's a bridge. Go over it. It's yours. I'm taking you through it. Asata, hate it. It's what ready. You know, sir. Yes, they are Ross. It's a bridge. It's a bridge. It's a bridge. He said it's not broken. It's not broken. The bridge is not broken. He's the monarch of the whole universe. Da 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 da. For had they known me, they would not have crucified me. They did because they did not know me. So also I said to you, they did not know you, they do not know you. But you know me. Know me. Because your place with me is sure, saith the Lord. A place with me is sure. Raza ture abasa. Esira katangra to saprade. Rata romacha. You unclean spirit. Specifically assigned against anybody. I confuse you now by the blood of the Lamb. I declare you confused. You are confused. In Jesus' name, I drive you out. I drive you out now. I command you, get out. In the name of Jesus, get out.
in the name of Jesus, get out!
It's the bridge. It's the bridge. It's the bridge. It's done. It's done. It's the bridge. I'm telling you. It's the bridge. The wicked has been spoken against. The Lord has spoken against the wicked. Victory has been mandated in the realm of the spirit. Is the bridge. Is the bridge. Is the bridge. Is the bridge. You know? Here. What happened? See, as I lay hands on you, I hear a Yoruba word. Yoruba word. You know? Yoruba. It was a Yoruba. It came in Yoruba language. Suranasa. I'm telling you, something has been born. I feel the day, I feel like the day I just got born again. It's called the washing of the word. He wash us with the water of the word. Listen, he said to everybody, you need to listen to this message again. Yes, that's true. Everybody share it. Take your phone. Wherever you are watching all over the world, and this teaching, whether it's halfway, just little, you know, or everything, it's a blessing to you. Share it right now. Let it go viral. Let it help set the body of Christ free. The burdens that we have brought upon ourselves. Everybody, go to Facebook. Share it. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Something is birthed in this service this evening. Something is born. Glorious thing. My prayer is that you will not only hear it, you have understanding of it. And you are able to communicate the same. The name of Jesus. There's no more confusion in destiny concerning us. This thing is settled. It's a fixed realm. Hallelujah. Share it. Just press the share button. Everybody. Share it on your Facebook. On all your platforms. Share it on your WhatsApp group. Messenger. Everywhere. Send it. Whether home and abroad. Let's help deliver our brethren, brothers and sisters. There's a pastor that is watching. They're watching me from Bayelsa. It's no word of knowledge. You just send me a message on my phone now. He's watching from Bayelsa. And the team bless him so much. He wants me to know. That's why he sent me. I want to let you know you are blessed. You are blessed. Some people think it's word of knowledge. What about God? Word of knowledge. No, it's not word of knowledge. It's word of text. We are not out to impress anybody now. Hallelujah. Now, wherever you are, the Bible says, what a man has spoken the word and it has blessed you, taught the word, and the word has blessed you. He says, you should give. Give. So I'm going to give you opportunity to give. Giving is part of our Christian life. You know, our Christian's obligation, duty, to give to the work of God. You know, so wherever you are, I'm going to give you opportunity to give. Take up an offering. You can give $100, $500, or $1,000. Wherever you are, all over the world. If you are in England, in London, if you can give £50, £100, give to support the work of God. Or in South Africa, wherever you are, in Canada, all over the world. If our teaching and ministry is a blessing to you, join us financially as well to move this thing forward. Please put the account details up there. I'm not going to ask all of you to give. Give generously. Don't just look. We have to learn to give so that we are not like the church at Corinth. The church at Corinth love the word, but they don't like to give. Don't be like that. Learn to give cheerfully. Everybody give at least 10,000 naira. Give. As a matter of fact, I want 10 people to give 10,000. 10. If you do, and you can give 10,000, please do. But if you don't want to give, you don't worry about it. I want 10 people to do it. To give 10,000. Our GT account is 001-686-4121. That's the GT account, Guarantee Trust Bank. And our Access Bank account is 14-333-73574. Our Zenith Bank account is 1001-488-167. Father, thank you for everyone that is giving right now. Thank you for the grace to give. Same way you gave us grace for the word. Thank you for the grace to give. Bless everyone's giving. Multiply every seed sown. To your glory and your praise, Father. In Jesus' precious name. I declare that the heaviness that anyone is experiencing spiritually is lifted and it will not return. I serve that devil final quit notice. You will not come back in Jesus' name. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name I pray. All right. Everybody do transfer. And then.